This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Chinese Exclusion Act was a United States federal law signed by President Chester A. Arthur on May 6, 1882. It was one of the most significant restrictions on free immigration in U.S. history, prohibiting all immigration of Chinese laborers. The act followed the Angel Treaty of 1880, a set of revisions to the U.S.-China Burlingame Treaty of 1868 that allowed the U.S. to suspend Chinese immigration. The act was initially intended to last for 10 years, but was renewed in 1892 with the Geary Act and made permanent in 1902. The Chinese Exclusion Act was the first law implemented to prevent a specific ethnic group from immigrating to the United States. It was repealed by the Magnuson Act on December 17, 1943. Contents 1. Background 2. The Act 3. Repeal and current status 4. See also 5. Footnotes 6. Further reading 7. External links. Background. Main article, History of Chinese Americans. This official map of Chinatown 1885 was published as part of an official report of a special committee established by the San Francisco Board of Supervisors on the condition of the Chinese Quarter, Chinese immigrant workers building the Transcontinental Railroad. The first significant Chinese immigration to North America began with the California Gold Rush of 1848-1855 and continued with subsequent large labor projects, such as the building of the first Transcontinental Railroad during the early stages of the Gold Rush. When surface gold was plentiful, the Chinese were tolerated, if not well received, as gold became harder to find and competition increased. Animosity toward the Chinese and other foreigners increased after being forcibly driven from the mines. Most Chinese settled in enclaves in cities, mainly San Francisco, and took up low-wage labor, such as restaurant and laundry work. With the post-Civil War economy in decline by the 1870s, anti-Chinese animosity became politicized by labor leader Dennis Kearney and his Workingman's Party, as well as by California Governor John Bigler, both of whom blamed Chinese coolies for depressed wage levels. Another significant anti-Chinese group organized in California during this same era was the Supreme Order of Caucasians, with some 60 chapters statewide in the early 1850s. There was resistance to the idea of excluding Chinese migrant workers from immigration, because they provided essential tax revenue which helped fill the fiscal gap of California. But toward the end of the decade, the financial situation improved, and subsequently, attempts to legislate Chinese exclusion became successful on the state level. In 1858, the California legislature passed a law that made it illegal for any person of the Chinese or Mongolian races to enter the state. However, this law was struck down by an unpublished opinion of the state Supreme Court in 1862. The Chinese immigrant workers provided cheap labor and did not use any of the government infrastructure, schools, hospitals, etc., because the Chinese migrant population was predominantly made up of healthy male adults. As time passed and more Chinese migrants arrived in California, violence would often break out in cities such as Los Angeles. By 1878, Congress decided to act and passed legislation excluding the Chinese, but this was vetoed by President Rutherford B. Hayes. In 1879, California adopted a new constitution, which explicitly authorized the state government to determine which individuals were allowed to reside in the state, and banned the Chinese from employment by corporations and state, county, or municipal governments. Once the Chinese Exclusion Act was finally passed in 1882, California went further by passing various laws that were later held to be unconstitutional after the act was passed. Most Chinese families were faced with a dilemma: stay in the United States alone or go back to China to reunite with their families. Although there was widespread dislike for the Chinese, some capitalists and entrepreneurs resisted their exclusion because they accepted lower wages. The act, for the first time, federal law proscribed entry of an ethnic working group on the premise that it endangered the good order of certain localities. The earlier Page Act of 1875 had prohibited immigration of Asian forced laborers and prostitutes, and the Naturalization Act of 1790 prohibited naturalization of non-white subjects. The act excluded Chinese laborers, meaning skilled and unskilled laborers and Chinese employed in mining, from entering the country for 10 years under penalty of imprisonment and deportation Revolution front page of the San Francisco Call November 20, 1901, Chinese Exclusion Convention. The Chinese Exclusion Act required the few nonlaborers who sought entry to obtain certification from the Chinese government that they were qualified to emigrate. However, this group found it increasingly difficult to prove that they were not laborers because the 1882 Act defined excludables as skilled and unskilled laborers and Chinese employed in mining. Thus, very few Chinese could enter the country under the 1882 law. Diplomatic officials and other officers on business, along with their house servants, for the Chinese government were also allowed entry as long as they had the proper certification verifying their credentials. The act also affected the Chinese who had already settled in the United States. Any Chinese who left the United States had to obtain certifications for re-entry, and the act made Chinese immigrants permanent aliens by excluding them from U.S. citizenship after the act's passage. Chinese men in the U.S. had little chance of ever reuniting with their wives, or of starting families in their new abodes. Amendments made in 1884 tightened the provisions that allowed previous immigrants to leave and return, and clarified that the law applied to ethnic Chinese regardless of their country of origin. The Scott Act 1888 expanded upon the Chinese Exclusion Act, prohibiting re-entry after leaving the U.S. Constitutionality of the Chinese Exclusion Act and the Scott Act was upheld by the Supreme Court in Chai Chan Ping v. United States 1889, the Supreme Court declared that the power of exclusion of foreigners an incident of sovereignty belonging to the government of the United States as a part of those sovereign powers delegated by the Constitution. The act was renewed for 10 years by the 1892 Geary Act, and again with no terminal date in 1902 when the act was extended in 1902. It required each Chinese resident to register and obtain a certificate of residence. Without a certificate, he or she faced deportation. Between 1882 and 1905, about 10,000 Chinese appealed against negative immigration decisions to federal court, usually via a petition for habeas corpus. In most of these cases, the courts ruled in favor of the petitioner except in cases of bias or negligence. These petitions were barred by an act that passed Congress in 1894 and was upheld by the U.S. Supreme Court in U.S. v. Lem Moon Singh 1895. In U.S. v. Ju Toi 1905, the U.S. Supreme Court reaffirmed that the port inspectors and the Secretary of Commerce had final authority on who could be admitted. Ju Toi's petition was thus barred despite the fact that the district court found that he was an American citizen. The Supreme Court determined that refusing entry at a port does not require due process and is legally equivalent to refusing entry at a land crossing. All these developments, along with the extension of the act in 1902, triggered a boycott of U.S. goods in China. Between 1904 and 1906 there was one 1885 case in San Francisco, however, in which Treasury Department officials in Washington overturned a decision to deny entry to two Chinese students. One of the critics of the Chinese Exclusion Act was the anti-slavery, anti-imperialist Republican Senator George Frisbie Hoar of Massachusetts, who described the act as nothing less than the legalization of racial discrimination. The laws were driven largely by racial concerns. Immigration of persons of other races was unlimited during this period. On the other hand, many people strongly supported the Chinese Exclusion Act, including the Knights of Labor, a labor union, who supported it because it believed that industrialists were using Chinese workers as a wedge to keep wages low among labor and leftist organizations. The industrial workers of the world were the sole exception to this pattern. The IWW openly opposed the Chinese Exclusion Act from its inception. In 1905, a political cartoon from 1882, showing a Chinese man being barred entry to the Golden Gate of Liberty. The caption reads, "We must draw the line somewhere, you know." Certificate of identity issued to Yi Weithing certifying that he is the son of a U.S. citizen, issued November 21, 1916. This was necessary for his immigration from China to the United States for all practical purposes. The Exclusion Act, along with the restrictions that followed it, froze the Chinese community in place in 1882. Limited immigration from China continued until the repeal of the Chinese Exclusion Act in 1943. From 1910 to 1940, the Angel Island Immigration Station on what is now Angel Island State Park in San Francisco Bay served as the processing center for most of the 56,113 Chinese immigrants who are recorded as immigrating or returning from China. Upwards of 30% more who showed up were returned to China. Furthermore, after the 1906 San Francisco earthquake, which destroyed City Hall and the Hall of Records, many immigrants known as Paper Sons claimed that they had familial ties to resident Chinese Chinese American citizens. Whether these were true or not cannot be proven. The Chinese Exclusion Act gave rise to the first great wave of commercial human smuggling, an activity that later spread to include other national and ethnic groups. The Chinese Exclusion Act also led to an expansion of the power of U.S. immigration law through its influence on Canada's policies on Chinese exclusion during this time because of the need for greater vigilance at the U.S.-Canada border. Shortly after the U.S.-Chinese Exclusion Act, Canada established the Chinese Immigration Act of 1885, which imposed a head tax on Chinese migrants entering Canada. After increasing pressure from the U.S. government, Canada finally established the Chinese Immigration Act, 1923, which banned most forms of immigration by the Chinese to Canada. There was also a need for this kind of border control along the U.S.-Mexico border. However, efforts to control the border went along a different path because Mexico was fearful of expanding imperial power of the U.S. and did not want U.S. interference in Mexico. Not only this, but Chinese immigration to Mexico was welcomed because the Chinese immigrants filled Mexico's labor needs. The Chinese Exclusion Act actually led to heightened Chinese immigration to Mexico because of exclusion by the U.S. Therefore, the U.S. resorted to heavily policing the border along Mexico later. The Immigration Act of 1924 restricted immigration even further, excluding all classes of Chinese immigrants and extending restrictions to other Asian immigrant groups until these restrictions were relaxed in the middle of the 20th century. Chinese immigrants were forced to live a life separated from their families, and to build ethnic enclaves in which they could survive on their own Chinatown. The Chinese Exclusion Act did not address the problems that whites were facing. In fact, the Chinese were quickly and eagerly replaced by the Japanese, who assumed the role of the Chinese in society. Unlike the Chinese, some Japanese were even able to climb the rungs of society by setting up businesses or becoming truck farmers. However, the Japanese were later targeted in the National Origins Act of 1924, which banned immigration from East Asia entirely. In 1891, the government of China refused to accept the U.S. Senator Mr. Henry W. Blair as U.S. Minister to China due to his abusive remarks regarding China during negotiation of the Chinese Exclusion Act. The American Christian Rev. Dr. George F. Pentecost spoke out against Western imperialism in China, saying, "I personally feel convinced that it would be a good thing for America if the embargo on Chinese immigration were removed. I think that the annual admission of 100,000 into this country would be a good thing for the country, and if the same thing were done in the Philippines, those islands would be a veritable Garden of Eden. In 25 years, the presence of Chinese workmen in this country would, in my opinion, do a very great deal towards solving our labor problems. There is no comparison between the Chinaman, even of the lowest coolie class, and the man who comes here from southeastern Europe, from Russia, or from southern Italy. The Chinese are thoroughly good workers. That is why the laborers here hate them. I think, too, that the emigration to America would help the Chinese. At least he would come into contact with some real Christian people in America. The Chinaman lives in squalor because he is poor. If he had some prosperity, his squalor would cease." Repeal and current status. The Chinese Exclusion Act was repealed by the 1943 Magnuson Act, during a time when China had become an ally of the U.S. against Japan in World War II. This repeal also occurred in the context of World War II, during which the U.S. fought against German Nazism and needed to embody an image of fairness and justice, and also during a time when the Japanese were becoming vilified. The Magnuson Act permitted Chinese nationals already residing in the country to become naturalized citizens and stop hiding from the threat of deportation, while the Magnuson Act overturned the discriminatory Chinese Exclusion Act. It only allowed a national quota of 105 Chinese immigrants per year, and did not repeal the restrictions on immigration from the other Asian countries. Large-scale Chinese immigration did not occur until the passage of the Immigration and Nationality Act of 1965. The crackdown on Chinese immigrants reached a new level in its last decade, from 1956 to 1965, with the Chinese Confession Program launched by the Immigration and Naturalization Service that encouraged Chinese who had committed immigration fraud to confess, so as to be eligible for some leniency in treatment. Despite the fact that the Exclusion Act was repealed in 1943, the law in California prohibiting non-whites from marrying whites was not repealed until 1948, in which the California Supreme Court ruled the ban of interracial marriage within the state unconstitutional in Perez v. Sharp. Other states had such laws until 1967, when the United States Supreme Court unanimously ruled in Loving v. Virginia that anti-miscegenation laws across the nation are unconstitutional. Even today, although all its constituent sections have long been repealed, Chapter 7 of Title 8 of the United States Code is headed "Exclusion of Chinese." It is the only chapter of the 15 chapters entitled 8 Aliens and Nationality that is completely focused on a specific nationality or ethnic group. On June 18, 2012, the United States House of Representatives passed a resolution introduced by Congresswoman Judy Chu that formally expresses the regret of the House of Representatives for the Chinese Exclusion Act, which imposed almost total restrictions on Chinese immigration and naturalization and denied Chinese Americans basic freedoms because of their ethnicity. The resolution had been approved by the U.S. Senate in October 2011. In 2014, the California legislature took formal action to pass measures that formally recognize the many proud accomplishments of Chinese Americans in California and to call upon Congress to formally apologize for the 1882 adoption of the Chinese Exclusion Act. Senate Republican leader Bob Huff R. Diamond Barr and incoming Senate President Pro Tem Kevin De Leon D. Los Angeles served as joint authors for Senate Joint Resolution S.J. R. 23 and Senate Concurrent Resolution 122. Seychelles Rupees SJR 23 acknowledges and celebrates the history and contributions of Chinese Americans in California. The resolution also formally calls on Congress to apologize for laws which resulted in the persecution of Chinese Americans, such as the Chinese Exclusion Act. Perhaps most importantly is the sociological implications for understanding ethnic, race relations in the context of American history. There is a tendency for minorities to be punished in times of economic, political and/or geopolitical crises. Times of social and systemic stability, however, tend to mute whatever underlying tensions exist between different groups in times of societal crisis, whether perceived or real. Patterns or retractability of American identities have erupted to the forefront of America's political landscape, often generating institutional and civil society backlash against workers from other nations, a pattern documented by Fong's research into how crises drastically alter social relationships. See also anti-Chinese legislation in the United States, Chinese Confession Program, Chinese Exclusion Policy of NASA, Chinese Massacre of 1871, Head Tax Canada, List of United States Immigration Legislation, New Zealand Head Tax Paper, Sun's Rock Springs Massacre, Sinophobia, United States v. Wong Kim Ark, which held that the Chinese Exclusion Act could not overrule the citizenship of those born in the U.S. to Chinese parents, White Australia Policy, Yamataya v. Fisher, Japanese Immigrant Case, Yellow Peril. Footnotes. Carrot Norton, Henry K. 1924, The Story of California from the Earliest Days to the Present, Chicago, A.C. McClurg. Carrot Cole, L. Sherrill, Chinese Exclusion, The Capitalist Perspective of the Sacramento Union, 1850-1882, California History, Volume 57, No. 1, The Chinese in California, Spring, 1978, pp. 8-31, published by California Historical Society. Carrot Chu, Kenneth and Liu, John, Hidden in Plain Sight, Global Labor Force Exchange in the Chinese American Population, 1880-1940, Population and Development Review, Volume 30, No. 1 March 2004, pp. 57-78, published by Population Council. Carrot Miller, Joaquin, The Chinese and the Exclusion Act, The North American Review, Volume 173, Number 541, Dec. 1901, pp. 782-789, published by University of Northern Iowa. Carrot ABCDE, Exclusion, Library of Congress, the 1st of September 2003, retrieved the 25th of January 2010. Of a People, ABC Clio P. Relations, 3rd ed. Oxford University Press, 2008, p. 51. Carat, America Not a Christian Nation, Says Dr. Pentecost. The New York Times, February 11, 1912, archived from the original on 25 March 2014. Carat, Bill Text, CAGOV. Text of 1880 Chinese Exclusion Treaty and 1882 Chinese Exclusion Act, P.B. Sorg. Chinese Exclusion Act from the Library of Congress. Chinese Exclusion Act, Menlo School. Chinese Exclusion Act 1882. R. Documents. Exclusion Act Case Files of Yi Weithing and Yi Bingqi, 2 Paper Sons. The Young Wing Project hosts the memoir of one of the earliest naturalized Chinese whose citizenship was revoked 46 years after having received it as a result of the Chinese Exclusion Act, an alleged wife, one immigrant in the Chinese Exclusion Era. Collection of primary source documents relating to the Chinese Exclusion Act, from Harvard University. Primary source documents and images from the University of California. The Rocky Road to Liberty, a documented history of Chinese American immigration and exclusion. Primary source documents documents and images related to the documentary Separate Lives, Broken Dreams, Saga of the Chinese Exclusion Act Era, e.g. political cartoons, immigrant case files and government correspondence from the National Archives v. E. Chinese American topics related groups Chinese Americans American-born Chinese Taiwanese American Hong Kong Americans Asian American hyphenated American Hakka Americans Hokkien and Hoklo Americans Fuzhou Americans History Chinese American history by location California Los Angeles San Francisco Hawaii, Illinois, Chicago, Massachusetts, Boston, Michigan, Detroit, Missouri, St. Louis, New York City, Puerto Rico, Texas, Dallas, Fort Worth, Houston, Washington, Seattle, Anti-Chinese Discrimination Legislation, Anti-Chinese Legislation, Anti-Cooley Act, Chinese Exclusion Act, Geary Act. Immigration Act of 1924 Cable Act Magnuson Act Immigration and Nationality Act of 1965 Events Chinese Massacre of 1871 Tape v. Hurley 1884 Issaquah Riot of 1885 Rock Springs Massacre 1885 Tacoma Riot of 1885-1885 Seattle Riot of 1886 Yik Wo v. Hopkins 1886 Hell's Canyon Massacre 1887 United States v. Wong Kim Ark 1898 Murder of Vincent Chin 1982 Indictment of Peter Liang 2016 Chinatowns Chinatowns in the Americas Chinatowns in the United States Chinatowns in Canada Chinatowns in Latin America Baltimore Boston Chicago Cleveland Denver Detroit Honolulu Houston Southwest East Downtown Loc, California Los Angeles Monterey Park, California Montville, Connecticut Newark New Jersey New Orleans, New York City, Manhattan, Brooklyn, Queens, Oakland, Philadelphia, Phoenix, Pittsburgh, Portland, Maine, Portland, Oregon, Providence, Rhode Island, Richardson, Texas, Rockville, Maryland, St. Louis, Salt Lake City, San Diego, San Francisco. Richmond District, Sunset District, San Gabriel Valley, San Jose, California, Seattle, Spokane, Washington, Stockton, California, Tacoma, Washington, Washington, D.C. Culture, Food, American Chinese Cuisine, Film, American Chinese Films, Terminology, Chinaman's Chants, Juke, Sing Events. Love Boat Education Chinese School Confucius Institute Transportation Chinatown Bus Lines Museums Museum of Chinese in America Chinese American Museum Cam Wa Chung Chinese Society Halls on Maui Ying on Association Chinese Staff and Workers Association Chinese for Affirmative Action Committee of 100 Organization of Chinese Americans Bing Kong Tong Hip Sing Association Banks Cathay Bank United International Bank Global Commerce Bank East West Bank Others Lists List of Chinese Americans List of U.S. Cities with Significant Chinese American Populations v. E. Immigration to the United States and related topics relevant colonial era, United States and international laws colonial era nationality law in the American colonies Plantation Act 1740 18th Century Naturalization Act 1790 Scott Act 1888 Immigration Act of 1891 Geary Act 1892-1900-1949 Naturalization Act 1906 Gentlemen's Agreement 1907 Immigration Act of 1907 Immigration Act 1917 Asian Barred Zone Emergency Quota Act 1921 Cable Act 1922 Immigration Act 1924 Tidings McDuffie Act 1934 Filipino Repatriation Act 1935 Nationality Act of 1940 Bracero Program 1942-1964 Magnuson Act 1943 War Brides Act 1945 Lou Seller Act 1946 1950-1999 UN Refugee Convention 1951 Immigration and Nationality Act 1952 Permanent Residence Visa Waiver Program Temporary Protected Status Asylum Green Card Lottery U.S. Visit Security Advisory Opinion E-Verify Section 287 Grams Government Organizations Department of Homeland Security Immigration and Customs Enforcement U.S. Border Patrol U.S. Customs and Border Protection Immigration and Naturalization Service INS Board of Immigration Appeals Supreme Court Cases United States v. Wong Kim Ark 1898 United States v. Bhagat Singh Thind 1923 United States v. Brignone Ponce 1975 Chamber of Commerce v. Whiting 2011 Related Issues and Events Economic Impact Guest Worker Program Human Trafficking Human Smuggling Immigration Reform Immigration Reduction Labor Shortage March for America Illegal Immigrant Population Reverse Immigration 2006 Protests Unaccompanied Minors from Central America List of people deported from the United States. Geography. Mexico. United States border. Canada. United States border. United States Border Patrol. Interior checkpoints. Proposed legislation. DREAM Act 2001-2010. Hour 4437-2005. McCain-Kennedy 2005. SKIL 2006. Comprehensive Immigration Reform Act 2006. STRIVE Act 2007. Comprehensive Immigration Reform Act 2007. Uniting American Families Act 2000-2013. Border Security, Economic Opportunity, and Immigration Modernization Act of 2013. SAFE Act 2015. Immigration Stations and Points of Entry. Angel Island, Castle Garden, East Boston, Ellis Island, Sullivan's Island, Washington Avenue. Operations Wetback 1954, Peter Pan 1960-1962, Babylift 1975, Gatekeeper 1994, Endgame 2003-2012, Frontline 2004-2005, Streamline 2005-present, Return to Sender 2006-2007. State Legislation. California DREAM Act 2006-2010, Arizona SB 1070-2010. Alabama HB 56 2011. Non-Governmental Organizations. Coalition for Humane Immigrant Rights of Los Angeles. Coalition for Comprehensive Immigration Reform. National Immigration Forum. Center for Community Change. We Are America. Alliance. CASA of Maryland. Mexica Movement. Mexicans Without Borders. Federation for American Immigration Reform. Minuteman Project. Minuteman Civil Defense Corps. California Coalition for Immigration Reform. Save Our State. Center for Immigration Studies. National Korean American Service. Numbarusa. Negative Population Growth. Migration Policy Institute. Utah Compact. Center for Migration Studies of New York. VE. Discrimination. General Forms. Ageism. Caste. Class. Skin Color. Gender. Genetic Height. Linguistic. Lookism. Mentalism. Racism. Rankism. Religious. Sexism. Sexualism. Sizeism. Speciesism. Supremacism. Social. AIDS. Stigma. Ableism. Adultism. Anti-albinism. Anti-autism. Anti-homelessness. Anti-intellectualism. Anti-intersex. Anti-left-handedness. Anti-masonry. Anti-Semitism. Autism. Atheophobia. Binarism. Biphobia. Elitism. Aphibiphobia. Ethnic hatred. Fetism. Genderism. Gerontophobia. Handicapism. Heteronormativity. Heterosexism. Homonegativity. Homophobia. Islamophobia. Leprosy. Stigma. Lesbophobia. Misandry. Misogyny. Nepotism. Pedophobia. Pregnancy. Reverse discrimination. Sectarianism. Shadism. Transmisogyny. Transphobia. White supremacy. Black supremacy. Xenophobia. Manifestations. Blood libel. Compulsory sterilization. Cultural genocide. Disability. Hate crime. Educational. Economic eliminationism. Employment. Ethnic cleansing. Ethnic joke. Ethnicide. Forced conversion. Gay bashing. Gendercide. Genocide. Examples. Glass ceiling. Group libel. Hate crime. Hate group.